In this video, we'll take a closer look at molar mass and practice converting moles to grams. As a reminder, a mole is a really, really big number, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd to be exact. And when we are talking about molar mass, we are referring to the mass in grams of one mole of a substance. The molar mass can be found on the periodic table. For example, the molar mass of sodium would be 22.99 grams. Again, this information can be found on the periodic table. When we are finding the molar mass for molecules or compounds rather than one element, we simply add the molar masses of all of the elements that make up that compound or molecule. For example, you find the molar mass of sodium chloride, NaCl, by taking 22.99, which is the molar mass of sodium, and adding that to 35.45, which is the molar mass of chlorine. When you add those numbers, 22.99 and 35.45, you find that the molar mass of sodium chloride is 58.44 grams per mole. The conversion factor that you use when you go from moles to grams will be this one here. There is one mole in the denominator, and then the molar mass of either the element or the compound is in the numerator. Let's do a conversion from moles to grams. How many grams are there in 3.51 moles of sodium? You always start problems like this by taking what is given in the problem and putting it in the upper left-hand corner of a conversion chart. In this case, you're given 3.51 moles of sodium. The next step is to bring the units down. So moles of sodium will go in the denominator in the next column of the chart. You're going from moles to grams, so you use the molar mass, which you find on the periodic table. And at this point, the units of moles of sodium will cancel because they appear in both the numerator and the denominator. Now you're ready to solve the problem. You simply multiply 3.51 times 22.99. Notice that grams of sodium is the unit that you have left in the numerator. So that is what the number is reported to, grams. When you multiply these numbers together, 3.51 times 22.99, you find that the mass of sodium in grams is 80.7. That's the same amount of sodium as in 3.51 moles of sodium. This next problem asks how many grams of sodium chloride are there in 1.29 moles of sodium chloride. So just as before, you take what's given, and notice this time the given information is about a compound, sodium chloride. Set up a conversion chart and bring down the units, moles of sodium chloride. You're trying to go from moles of sodium chloride to grams of sodium chloride. Use the molar mass of sodium chloride, as discussed earlier, and notice that the units from moles of sodium chloride cancel because they appear in both the numerator and the denominator. All that's left to do now is multiply 1.29 times 58.44, and the answer is 75.4 grams. And that's 75.4 grams of sodium chloride, which is the mass of 1.29 moles of sodium chloride. This next problem is a stoichiometry problem involving molar mass. The problem states that hydrogen and oxygen gas can be generated through the electrolysis of water. The balanced chemical equation is 2 moles of water yields 2 moles of hydrogen plus 1 mole of oxygen. The question asks how many grams of oxygen could be produced from the decomposition of 2.8 moles of water. The first thing you do is put what's given, 2.8 moles of water, in the upper left-hand corner of the conversion chart. Now, the question is asking to convert to grams of oxygen, and you're starting with water. So what you're going to have to do is use the mole ratio to get from water to oxygen. And these coefficients from the balanced equation will allow you to do that. So bring down the units, which are moles of water. And in this problem, you convert to moles of oxygen first. Again, that's the mole ratio step. And there are 2 moles of water for every 1 mole of oxygen, according to the balanced equation. So you put a 2 for the water and a 1 for the oxygen. Notice that the units of moles of water cancel because they appear in the numerator and the denominator. You can't stop the calculation here, though, because if you stopped, you'd be solving for moles of oxygen. And the question asked for grams of oxygen. So you continue to use the conversion chart. Draw another box now and bring moles of oxygen down. And in this step, you're going from moles of oxygen to grams of oxygen, which is what you were asked to solve for. Use the molar mass of oxygen, and again, you can find this by adding two oxygens together from the periodic table. One mole of oxygen has a mass of 32.0 grams, and here again, you can cancel out units, this time the moles of oxygen. Now you have grams of oxygen in the upper right-hand corner of the conversion chart, and this is what you were solving for, so you're done with the converting part. All that's left to do is multiply 2.8 times 1 times 32, and then divide that by the product of 2 times 1, which is just 2. Once you do that multiplication, and then divide that by 2, your answer is 45 grams of oxygen, rounded to two significant figures. According to this reaction, if 2.8 moles of water were to react, then you could produce 45 grams of oxygen. This next problem involves the reaction that is used to create sodium chloride, or common table salt. 2 moles of sodium will react with 1 mole of chlorine to produce 2 moles of sodium chloride. The question asks, how many grams of sodium chloride can be produced from the excess sodium and 47.00 grams of chlorine gas? Just as before, the first step is to take what's given, in this case the 47.00 grams of chlorine, and put that in the upper left-hand corner of the conversion chart. Next, bring the units down. That's grams of chlorine that go down here. Since we are trying to convert to moles of chlorine gas in this step, we will use the molar mass of chlorine gas, which is 70.91 grams, and place that in the denominator. And then place 1 mole of chlorine in the numerator. Notice the units of grams of chlorine will cancel. And you need to make another box because, as of now, we've only converted to moles of chlorine. But what you've been asked to solve for is grams of sodium chloride, not moles. So bring the units down again. Moles of chlorine will go down here. And you're trying to convert to moles of sodium chloride, so that goes here. From the balanced equation, there's an understood 1 in front of chlorine, and there's a 2 in front of sodium chloride. So put a 1 down here in the denominator for moles of chlorine, and a 2 in the numerator for sodium chloride. And again, you can cancel out the units. You've converted to moles of sodium chloride, but you need to keep going because the question wants grams of sodium chloride. So bring the units down again. That would be moles of sodium chloride in the denominator, and you'll convert that to grams of sodium chloride. This is where you use the molar mass from the periodic table, and if you remember, the molar mass of sodium chloride is 58.44 grams. Notice the units of moles of sodium chloride cancel out again, and now you have the unit that you're solving for, grams of sodium chloride. That means that you're done converting, so now just multiply 47.00 times 1 times 2 times 58.44, put that in the numerator, and divide it by the product of 70.91 times 1 times 1, which will just be 70.91. And when you do that math, you get 77.47 grams of sodium chloride. And that is how much sodium chloride can be produced, according to this reaction, if you use 47.00 grams of chlorine gas. Here's a problem for you to try on your own. Sodium chloride is produced from the reaction between sodium metal and chlorine gas. You can see the balanced chemical equation here. How many grams of sodium chloride can be produced from 1.7 moles of sodium in excess chlorine gas? Go ahead and press pause and give it a try. And then when you think you have the answer, press play and check your work. Here is the setup for this problem. We took 1.7 moles of sodium and put it in the upper left-hand corner of the conversion chart, and then brought the units down, the moles of sodium, and then we converted from moles of sodium to moles of sodium chloride. These twos came from the coefficients in the balanced equation. We then brought moles of sodium chloride down and converted from moles of sodium chloride to grams of sodium chloride using the molar mass of sodium chloride from the periodic table that we discussed earlier. When we multiply 1.7 times 2 times 58.44 and then divide that by 2 times 1, which is 2, we find that 99 grams of sodium chloride can be produced if we use 1.7 moles of sodium in excess chlorine gas according to this reaction right here. Did you get it right? If you got 99 grams, that's great. That's a closer look at molar mass and converting moles to grams. For more chemistry matters, go to our homepage where the entire series is available to you.